When you still place your tiles by hand, one after another, then you should definitely watch this. Auto-tiling is a cool feature which automatically places your tiles based on rules you set. And the best thing, it's easy to achieve without any coding required. I start with a new 2D project. I open the Package Manager under Window and go to the Unity Registry tab. Currently, the 2D Tilemap Extras package is not fully released. If you can see it, fine, but if not, click on this little settings icon and go to Advanced Project Settings. Here activate the Enable Preview Packages box. Now you should see it and can install it. But if you still can't see it, you may use the Unity 2021 beta version, where it's not visible at the time of recording. But you can install it by going to this little plus icon and select Add Package by Name, and just enter its name. It will automatically install by clicking on Add. So the package should now be installed. I added this chocolate tilemap from a Kenny Assets pack, because chocolate! And also a rectangular tilemap. In a new folder I called Tiles, I'll create a so-called rule tile and a 2D tiles rule tile. In the inspector dialog, we can now easily create our rules as long as they are not too special. This would require some coding. As it says on the right, we need to add sprites. I use a centerpiece as the default one. If you configured everything right, this won't bother at the end. I also add this one as the first rule. In the grid on the right, you can specify this rule by clicking on the field. A green arrow means that another tile must be adjacent. A red cross means that there mustn't be anything. The little bubble in the center represents the position of this current tile. If not open, click there at the bottom to open this preview. This looks a bit odd now, because our rule set is not done. But based on what your tileset will be, this is also not reliable to look at. I highly recommend to test your rules live. Drag your created rule tile in a palette and draw something on your tile map. As you can see, our top tile is already applied render rules match. When we now add another rule, we can see the changes. So this helps a lot if you're not quite sure where to put arrows or crosses. I won't add everything now, but let me show you some other cool features. Based on your tiles, you may also must watch out for the diagonal adjacent ones, like in this case. By checking the Extend Neighbor checkbox, you can even spread your rules out further, which can handle more complex cases. This diagonal one here is not applied, but rather the center tile. The reason here is it looks almost the same, but the one cross. The center rule is ranked higher in this list, so it is applied first. We could just drag it below, or better, specify the rule even more. If you have more than one tile for the same spot, you can change the output to random and increase the size of this list. And now drag your other sprites in. It will now automatically add one of the sprites in the list. By changing the noise slider, you can change the random factor which will be used. So now there are more tiles with candy on top. Great! You can also let the tiles rotate randomly, or mirror along the X or Y axis, or both of them. In this case, the tiles don't change when mirroring along the X axis. So, yeah. Another cool feature are animated tiles. You can create them separately, but also inside a rule like this. How about you can't jump on those tiles when there's candy because, well, you want to eat the candy. Let's switch to another project. This is how a default rule tile looks like in this preview window. With this tile I can create those basic shapes. But I also have these paths, which are three tiles wide. A fully centered one and two small border pieces. The rules only look good when drawing all three pieces. This is easy by using this rectangular drawing tool. but the preview of this rule tile looks just strange. That's why I recommend to test your rules right inside your scene. If you're interested in more, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.